Good morning. Welcome to my workshop. The thing that we're going to build now is this quarter scale Belanca Decathlon kit from Pilot in Japan. It's an ancient kit and it has a little bit of history that touches me a little bit, and I would like to tell you about it, whether you like to hear it or not. And let's take a look at what's in the box. Now, here I've opened the box, and out of it we get all kinds of plastic things. This is ABS plastic. This is the cowling, for example, and we have some clear plastic. This is the roof of the cabin, and we've got seats. We've got the dashboard cover and more of these things. Now, what we also get are bags of tiny little things made out of balsa wood that have been formed by Pilot. This was nearly unique to them. Nobody gave you 10 millimeter balsa wood that had already been cut. They would give you 10 millimeter balsa wood that was printed on, and you had to cut it yourself. This was in the 1980s, remember, long before anything called laser cutting or CNC. So the balsa wood, where you had parts that needed to be cut out, Pilot did it for you. They stamped them out using extremely sharp knives and stamping machines. I'm not really sure how they did it, and actually some of it was a secret, a top secret. Nobody was supposed to know how they did it. Other people, of course, did stamping like this, but the thing that put Pilot ahead of everybody else was how they stamped plywood. This, for example, is 3 millimeter plywood, and they would stamp it with these sharp knives and stamp the parts completely loose. Now, if the knives weren't sharp enough, they would just crush the wood, but in this case they would usually go through and you just got the parts out. And this was quite unique for Pilot or OK Model Company. Now, I'm going to take a picture of this of these boards, and you can see how good the stamping is. That was the plywood, and here's some balsa wood. All right. Another thing that distinguished Pilot was the plans. Their plans were really, really good. They were clear, they were concise, they were detailed. Very, very good. What, however, was not good from Pilot were the instructions. For example, in this kit, this piece of paper here are the instructions. You've got pictures, 28 pictures, and you've got instructions in English, in Japanese, and in German. That's it. They are far from detailed. That's where they dropped the ball. Very, very bad. Now, I told you that this particular kit had a little history. And here it is. I started in modelling around about 1979, which are a number of years ago. And soon after I started in the models, I got a job in the shop that sold the models. Yeah. Now, the man who owned the shop, he liked the pilot kits a lot, and he imported to the country many of them, including three of these. Now, one of them was built in the 1980s, and it still exists, and it is absolutely fantastic model. It's a model of an aeroplane called registered TF-MBL, and it was completely scale, 100% scale. It was so fantastic. Now, one of the kits was probably sold and nothing came of it, but the third one was sold north to Akureyri, where I got my hands on it, and now I'm going to build it. And it's very likely that I myself put this kit in the mail and sent it to Akureyri sometime early 1980s. Now, what I want to do now, because this kit is quite old and a lot of people have gone through it and looked at it, I want to see that everything that should be in the box is in the box. And for that, Pilot have given me a part list. Here it is, on the back of the instructions, in English, Japanese, and German. Now, I understand the German a little bit. I do not understand any of the Japanese. And the English list is okay, I understand English. However, for some reason, they have put imperial measurements in the English list and millimeters in the German. So I'll have to jump between these to verify that what I think is the measurement in imperial is indeed what it is in metric. And of course, I'm going to use metric because that's what the whole world uses, apart from America. So there. So after I've gone through, we'll start building. See you then. Now I have completed my survey of the kit, and everything seems to be in it that's supposed to be there, except for one 8mm formed trailing edge list, W7. I can't find that. Everything else is there, and I've put these things into groups. Over there is the fuselage. That's most of the fuselage. Here are all the small bits. Here we have the wing parts. Here are the stabilizer parts, and here are the fin parts, the fin and rudder. So I can start building. One thing was not as it should have been. All the plastic parts are okay, except for this one. This is the nose of the cowling, and this plastic part has gone yellow and is brittle and is breaking. So what I'm going to have to do when I put the cowling together is to make a plaster cast of this and then cast it in glass fiber. It will not be a problem, it's quite easy, it's a small part, but I cannot use this on the aeroplane, it'll just crumble away. So that's about it for this video. I can start building, and what I'm going to do is to take these instructions here, and especially the photographs, and make one video from each photograph. So again, for example, I take photograph number one and use instructions for this photograph to make whatever it is that is in video photograph number one. And so this might be 28 or 30 videos in all. So until next time, thank you very much for watching.